everyone. Welcome to our Fighting Illini Football Preview Show. I'm Ryan Baker. I'll be your host for the next 60 minutes as we count down to the season opener against Murray State. That first Saturday in September is right around the corner when a sea of orange and blue will flood Grange Grove and head into Memorial Stadium to witness the start of the Lovie Smith era in Champaign. Coming up on the show, I'll sit down with our new head football coach to get his thoughts on his team and his return to the college game. We'll also hear from a few key members of Lovie Smith's coaching staff, offensive coordinator Garrick McGee and defensive coordinator Hardy Nickerson. We'll have a few player surprises for you too. Illinois Director of Athletics Josh Whitman will join me as well. So sit back, relax, and get ready for an inside look at your 2016 Fighting Illini football squad. We'll kick things off after a quick timeout.
It's hard not to be a fan of a credit card that gives you more while saving you money every single day. The Illini Visa Rewards Card, available only through U of I Community Credit Union.
Welcome back to our Fighting Illini Football Preview Show. Football fans across the state became very familiar with Lovie Smith during his highly successful run as head coach of the Chicago Bears. Well, now he's wearing the original orange and blue in Illinois, colors near and dear to Papa Bear himself. Now, I know that Lovie and I are lookalikes, but here is visual proof that we can be in the same place at the very same time. I recently sat down with the 25th head coach in Fighting Illini football history to chat with him about teaching the game to college athletes after two decades away from campus life and his plan to build a championship program here in Champaign. But first, let's go back to the whirlwind courtship that landed Coach Smith here at U of I back in March.
We will win. It's important. That's what everybody's thirsty for. We don't get in this to come in second place. That's not our purpose.
I'm going to go out and sell our university. We're going to sell our plan. So that's going to be my focus as much as anything else.
Well, I can say that everyone is excited. He came in with a lot of juice, came in just with a lot of confidence, you know, and which gave us a lot more confidence. I could see it in the team's eyes.
Excited. Heard a lot of speculation about who our coach was, and I think today the players were relieved to find out who it was. Mr. Whitman was right when he said he was going to have a plan, and he had it quick, and I think the players are excited moving forward.
Well, Coach, it seems like 5 months have just flown by since you took over the reins of the Fighting Illini football program. How excited are you to finally be approaching the days coming where you can get down to doing what you do best, and that's coaching football, getting ready for that season opener on September 3rd against Murray State?
Very excited, Ryan. It has been, seemed like it was yesterday, but a lot has happened during that time. Early on, you don't know any of the players, you don't know the surroundings. You have all of that now down, but you're doing all that getting ready for this season. The guys have been working extremely hard, and football is right around the corner.
You have assembled a very impressive coaching staff, starting with your coordinators on defense, Hardy Nickerson. I remember years ago, early in my career, after I left Channel 3 in Champaign, I went to San Diego, and Hardy was still playing for the Chargers. So just like we're dating ourselves, but still, I was always impressed with his you know, just how competitive he was and his focus. I mean, this guy, you knew he meant business, and he carried that through his career. Now in the coaching, you have him leading your defense, and then Garrick McGee on offense. I mean, these are two accomplished coaches, yeah. And you have other great coaches on your staff. How are you able to assemble such a good staff so quickly?
Well, I guess an advantage to being in the profession as long as I have, I've had a chance to work with a lot of different people and see them in different positions. And that's what it has helped me. You know, I started off a long time ago, early on when I first got in coaching, got a chance to recruit mm-hmm. Garrick McGee, and I saw him grow up as a player, and then to see him get into the coaching profession. And it's never worked out where we've been able to work on the same staff at the same time. But this time it did. It was just a match made in heaven a little bit. Really believing what he's, who he is as a, not just as a coach, but as a leader of our men. Mm. So our fans will love the excitement that our offense will show each week. And yes, Hardy Nickerson. It's one thing though to be a great player. Mm. Some players are you know have a great career. And then there are some players that can really play football, and you see that they have a lot of coaching qualities while they're playing. That's what Hardy Nickerson brought to the table.
He was a natural leader, wasn't he?
He was a natural leader, coach on the field, and I thought it was a natural thing for him to go into the coaching profession. So I know not only what they're going to bring, you know, as far as expertise football-wise, but just leading our men each day. And Bob Likoszewski, too. Mm. We're going to win games with special teams. I've known Bob for a long time. So these leaders would do a good job.
Was Hardy Nickerson Jr. part of the deal, or was that just a bonus that came out of
Ryan, that was just a bonus, but I've seen Hardy Nickerson grow up from an infant. So, you know, what a special season, too, you know, for me to have, you know, one of my all-time favorite players that I had an opportunity to coach, along with his son, you know, being one of our leaders on our team. So it's a lot of things to really get excited about.
What are your personal expectations of your players? I mean, I know you're not going to put a win total out there you think you're going to hit, but, you know, each and every Saturday when they suit up or each and every practice, what do you expect from your young men?
Well, it's pretty simple. We just want them to come out each day. We're all about playing hard, maximum effort throughout. We want our fans to leave when they leave Memorial Stadium or any other stadium mm-hmm. to talk about how hard we play. Mm-hmm. So there's a standard. We're going to be a disciplined football team and play to the best of our ability each week. I mean, those are the initial goals that we'll have.
Have you learned the school song yet?
Well, I'm not a singer, so I won't be singing an awful lot.
But you do want to be singing Victory Illinois after games on Saturdays.
We definitely want to do that, and there are some things that are special to the University of Illinois. Our players are educating me to a lot of those. Can't wait to get started.
That's what I was going to ask you, learning the culture and the history. I mean,
absolutely.
And you are a football historian. You know the history of the game, but even the little nuances of what the culture is like being part of the Illini Nation. What's that been like for you?
It has been great. And we've had a chance to go all over the state, mm-hmm. Talking to our alumni, our fans about, you know, the direction of our program. And each week, I will say that it has been an education. Mm. People, our fans, reaching out, telling me special stories about their time at the University of Illinois. And as much as anything, just about the support. Coach will be there this fall. And there is no better statement than that. Coach will be there in the fall supporting us. They know that, you know, it's going to take everybody for us to make this move back to a team that's being talked about each year, but we'll do it.
Well, the Lovie effect is in full effect. Coach, always a pleasure.
Sure thing.
Thank you,
Ryan.
In switching from the pro game back to college football, Coach Smith knew that a strong staff would make his transition much easier. One of the first calls that he made after getting the job here at Illinois was to Garrick McGee. As the Illini's offensive coordinator, McGee is a trusted aide with an innovative mind and has a wealth of college football experience, which includes a previous stop in the Big Ten and a brief stint as a head coach.
Let's go. How are we feeling?
Good, how are you, Coach?
Gotta have a good day, man. Gotta have a good day.
Taco Tuesday on Thursday.
Is Taco Tuesday on Thursday? Index finger to groin. There you go. Push that point back, man. Jeff, I want you to hold it straight, turn your shoulder, and spit it out. There you go. Quickest release possible. Left, right. Make sure your back foot's under your hip though. Long strides. Hitch, hitch. That's good. Still got to be accurate. But Chase, don't look out there. Look straight. Train your eyes to look straight to the zero spot. Rotate, sprint. That's a good rep. Set. Hey, but still your back hand tucked in your belly button. One, two. That's the way you make it smooth. Rhythm, rhythm, Wes. There you go, it's easy to catch that one. Front side hash, back side hash, check down. Tuck the ball away. Sam, use your footwork in your releases. Don't just hop into him and use your hands. Don't look, keep your eyes in the middle. You still look too soon. Yeah, just go left, keep the mic moving. Then when you turn to go right, he'll break open at the right time. You don't want to see everything. Darian, it's man, break and run away from him. Don't just stand there, he's got your man. Listen, a ball thrown out of bounds, you should have to pay the fans for coming. Throw it in bounds and give him a chance at making a catch on the ball. To throw it out of bounds wastes every receiver and everybody's time. What's the route?
Go.
That's a great timing, Chase. He got hell right there. And that ball is catchable. That's great timing, though. Ball.
Oh! Run through the bump. Run through it.
You gave him a chance, and he made a one-handed catch. The only way you can make one-handed catch is if you give him a chance at the ball.
Well, with me here on set now is Illini Offensive Coordinator Garrick McGee. Coach, welcome to Champaign.
Sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Don't leave me hanging, man. We just got it out. But you know what? There's so many questions about the offense headed into the season. For years, the offense was the unit that carried the Illini, but the defense has taken over that role. As you step in as the new OC, all the conversations start with Wes Lunt, your quarterback, his efficiency, but trying to keep him upright. He wasn't sacked a whole lot, but maybe a little more balance on your offense between the run and the pass. How can you look to achieve that this season?
Well, it's an emphasis. I think that the way that you move the ball is you have balance. Mm-hmm. The defense and the defensive coordinator has to think about defending the run and the pass. Mm-hmm. And that's the way you keep them off balance. If you do anything and, you know, that's all you do, then they're, you know, nowadays coaches are really good. They can figure out how to stop that. Mm-hmm. So you got to be able to run it, play action pass, use your drop back passing game on third downs.
And, you know, with the running game, was the bottom of the Big Ten a year ago, but you got a guy a lot of people saying could be that bell cow back and Keyshawn Vaughn. What have you seen from him from coming in here in the spring and throughout training camp heading into the season opener?
Yeah, well, you know, we recruited Keyshawn before, so I'm very familiar with him and what he did in high school and how explosive and how good he was in high school.
So you had seen his tape already.
I've seen a lot of Keyshawn, talk with him and, talk with his mother. So I have a relationship with Keyshawn before we got here. But I think that, it's not just him. You know, running the ball, you know, it starts with the quarterback. And the quarterback gets us in the right plays to make sure we're running the ball into the right defenses. And then our offensive line, they set the front and they make the point and then they get off and make the blocks. The receivers have to make their blocks on the perimeter outside to block safeties dropping down. Mm-hmm. And then the running back gets the ball and he has to find the path and understand where he's going. So, you know, football is an 11-man operation, you know, if you're running it or throwing it. So it really all starts with the quarterback. We're fortunate to have Wes. Wes has a really good understanding of the game. Mm-hmm. He understands fronts, understands how coverages fit behind fronts and where the weakness of the defense to run the ball first. And I think that he's really committed to that because he understands that that'll take a lot of pressure off him if we have a solid running game.
And he protects the football too. He doesn't make a lot of costly mistakes, has it up to this point. Have you seen that, his maturity?
Well, I think the kid is no one ever talks about Wes. I'm a football junkie, so I read everything that's said about, you know, every team, trying to figure out which teams in the Big Ten have certain players or what they're saying about each Big Ten. Mm. And, you know, no one ever talks about Wes as one of the top quarterbacks in the country. And you're talking about somebody that has started at Oklahoma State in the Big 12. Mm-hmm. He's been here playing. Now he's a senior and he's got weapons around him. He's tall, he can deliver the ball all over the field. He has a really good understanding of the game. And so we're just looking forward to getting out on the field and proving that this kid is one of the top quarterbacks in the country.
Are the questions about his mobility fair?
I think that, you know, people question Tom Brady and Peyton Manning's mobility.
It worked out pretty well for them.
Yeah,
huh?
So I don't know that there's different styles of quarterbacks. Mm-hmm. So I think that, you know, you try to find things that are wrong with the kid mm-hmm. instead of just talking about what he does great.
Mm-hmm. Let's talk about your receivers. Of course, it would be great to have Mikey Dudek out here, but mm-hmm. unfortunately he's recovering from another really tough injury that he suffered in the spring. But you've got some other guys who've had the opportunity to step up, and Justin Hardy. I keep hearing about MJ McGriff, this freshman, little guy, but everybody, his name keeps floating around camp. Who's impressed you so far?
You know, they've impressed me as a group. Mm-hmm. Justin is fast, he's competitive, he's strong. Malik Turner has the ability to get in and out of breaks. He's fast, he's made a lot of plays on the field. DJ's played for a long time out here. So there's a bunch of guys. I think Zach Grant is a kid as an inside receiver that understands how to read coverages, understands where the open slots on the field are. Dom Thiemann is a freshman that we're really excited about, along with MJ. Dez is a kid that has shown production, you know, on the field. So I'm really excited that we're going to be able to play multiple kids. Mm-hmm. And that's how you stay fresh throughout the game. And it gives yourself an opportunity to win in the end because you're fresh. Mm-hmm. And to do that, you have to have depth and those guys flying around the field, you know, for four straight quarters.
Getting a chance to get out there. What have you seen so far from the offensive line in camp and guys stepping up around your center, Joe Spencer?
Well, I think that Luke does a really good job of teaching those kids what it means to be a line. Mm-hmm. And taking a lot of pride in being the offensive line. The Big Ten is a conference that, you know, once you get to October and November, the weather's gonna change. It's gonna get physical. Mm-hmm. The line of scrimmage is where the game's gonna be won. And, you know, Luke does a really good job with those kids, I believe, in teaching them that it's tough to be an O-lineman. You know, we're not gonna get any of the credit. But if things are working well, the only reason it's working well is because of us.
Right. Coach, always a pleasure. Great spending time with you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. See you out there on the field. All right. We'll be back with more on our Fighting Illini Football Preview Show.
Looking for a card that gives you more? Illini Visa Rewards Card. Earn points every day to fly any airline, anytime, no blackout dates. The Illini Visa Rewards Card. Available only through U of I Community Credit Union.
Anyone who has followed Lovie Smith's career knows that defense is his calling card. Who better to help teach his vaunted Tampa 2 system than a guy who played it for him at an NFL All-Pro level? There weren't many linebackers better than Hardy Nickerson. These days, though, the Illini's defensive coordinator is focused on making a talented group even better.
Let's get a break real quick. Here we go. Ready, break, on three. Ready, one, two, three, break. Good. Good. Nice job, Jamal. Good, Chump. Good, Smoot. I see you. We good? We good? Here we go. Bring them up and get a break. Bring them up and break them down. Let's go. Here we go. Hustle over, hustle over, hustle over, hustle over. That's it. That's it right there. Nice job, Bang. Find it. Punch it out. Find it. Find it. And scoop it.
Double your points, baby. Double your points.
Chunky, right there. Right there. Locate the ball. Punch the belly of the ball. I'm going to punch this part of the ball. Pop right out. Let's start right here. Start right here. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Here we go. Turn it left. Say go. One, two, three, back down. Turn. Good turns, good turns. We're gonna run a fade. We're running a fade. Here we go. Set, go. Catch him and trail him. Catch and trail. Catch and trail. Let's run that one more time. Here we go. Flat foot. All right. All right, all right, all right. Take a little bit of a wider alignment on him. So even though he starts all that shaking, you're taking away outside and only giving him one way to go. When he comes off stemming real hard, shaking, trying to shake you, if you get on your heels, he's got you. All right, so step to him proactive, let him know he's got one way to go, and that's it, all right? Taylor, we just pawed at him. That's called being a vet right there, all right? So what can you do better right there?
Because I did this. So I stepped here and just one more.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
Yeah. All right. I know I'm going to get the job done. I don't know and no one that could cover.
Well, Lovie Smith isn't the only one who's transitioning from the pro game to college. Hardy Nickerson, the Illini's defensive coordinator. You were the linebackers coach with the San Francisco 49ers when you got the call from Lovie to come to Champaign. Why did you say yes?
Well, I had spent the last two seasons with Lovie in Tampa Bay.
Right.
And when Lovie was let go, I was hired immediately by the 49ers. Mm-hmm. And had been there all of about a month.
Right.
And I got a call from Lovie, and he said he was headed here, and he was asking me to come along with him. And I didn't have any second thoughts.
Really?
Not at all. Really? Lovie and I had been, you know, he coached me for a number of years.
This is going back to your days with the Buccaneers.
Going back to my days with the Buccaneers as a player.
When he was a linebackers coach.
When he was a linebackers coach, yep. And we developed a great relationship then, and that's just carried all throughout. Even as a player, coach would always ask me, hey, Hardy, you ever think about coaching? And
you were known as the coach on the field when you were playing.
Kind of, yeah, because, you know, I made
all
the calls.
Saw those things in you.
Saw all those things, yep. Yep. So he stayed after me on it. You know, and then when he went to St. Louis, you know, he and I would talk all the time. He continuously asked me if I had thought about coaching. And at that time, my kids were small and just growing up. And I was like, man, I just can't see myself coaching right now. But lo and behold, when he got the job in Chicago, they had gone to the Super Bowl after the Super Bowl year. He hired me as his linebackers coach. Mm.
Lovie Smith and the Tampa 2 are synonymous, but you don't really see that system a lot in college football. NFL fans, certainly, you know, fans that follow the Bears here close to the U of I are familiar with it. But can you explain the basic philosophy of the Tampa 2 and how your current personnel is fitting in with that?
Yeah, you know, we're 4-3. If you look at us, four down linemen, three linebackers, and you know, so that's our front. That's what we operate. That's the structure which everything is built off of. Mm. So within that, you know, we do a lot of different things with the defense. I can't say a whole lot.
That's
right,
so you're not gonna give anything away.
I can't give any trade
secrets
away.
Some other coaches might be watching the show to say, well, you know, they want to get that on.
But
tape.
we feel like we have the personnel that fits real well what we do.
And certainly up front, because you know, everything's predicated on that pressure up front, and you got pretty good. Four pretty good ones up front, led by Dawuane Smoot.
Yeah, and he is a premier guy. To have him, Carroll Phillips, Bain,
Chunky
Clemens, Jamal Milan, Tito Odenigbo, Jamel President now. You know, we have guys that really fit really well what we plan to do up front. And some guys that can really get after the passing. At the second level, at the linebacker level, we feel real good about our guys here. You know, Hardy, my son, Trey Watson, James Crawford, Justice Williams. You know, so Mike Satina, we feel real good about, you know, where we're headed. Julian Jones is another guy in that group. You know, we feel like we got guys that fit how we want to play at the second level. And then in the secondary, you know, even though mentioning guys that hadn't had much playing experience in the past, but they're gonna. I feel like they fit well what we're doing, and they'll do real well. And on the back end, Dunlap and Taylor Barton, you know, those guys would probably be the anchors on the back end. Mm-hmm. You know, and then we got competition at the strong safety position and the right corner position, and those guys are fighting and battling, and we'll see who comes with it.
But this is where the work
gets done and you put the work in and you want to see the results on Saturdays, you got the big smile on your face. You're loving being here to Illinois, wearing the orange and blue and that representing that eye. Hardy, thanks a lot, man.
Thank you.
Look forward
to
seeing the work on the field.
Thank you.
We've shown you a few sights from Fighting Illini football training camp, but now we're about to turn up the sound with safety Taylor Barton and receiver Malik Turner.
Another day in the office, baby. Let's get money today, baby.
I do the same thing I do every day. Doing the same stuff I do every day. Nothing changed. I got juice every day. You know I bring it every day.
Watch out for us, man. We coming. Put your 3D glasses on. We coming straight at you.
Oh, okay. That was a good one. Remember, you want some?
Switch! Do it! Close left. I got this. Vegas, 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 Vegas. Hey, gut! Roll out! Whoa! Oh, the play cast.
So just be alert for cover two. Cover two, take it up the seam. Slash, slash.
Chill out.
Blocking.
You look a little tired, Coach.
Hey, I need some water too.
Come on. Is that a hold? Ref. Ref, did I hold on that?
No, you gotta get right here, man. Get inside.
Yeah, MJ!
Sean Wright, knock eight farm on one, center on one.
Show it, show it, show it, show it. Malik, that's soft. Malik, that's better. But you do this. You come in there, last second, you're like, I don't know. And you sit back. Just boom, put your hands right in front of your head. So you don't hit your head, you'll hit your hands and then go.
Coming up after the break, I'll be joined here on set by defensive leader Dawuane Smoot and the anchor of the offensive line, Joe Spencer.
Hail to the orange. Hail to the blue. Hail alma mater. Ever so true. We love no other. So let our motto be victory. Illinois. Varsity.
Well, the reason I'm a little underdressed here on the set with Joe Spencer, the center for the Fight the Illini, and Dawuane Smoot, defensive end, is because it's been media day. You guys have been, you know, doing interviews and taking pictures. DJ, you like to be called, you've been getting a lot of attention. How have you managed that with all of the expectations for you coming into a season when your head coach, Lovie Smith, constantly refers to you as a first-round draft pick, where you can focus on preparing for the season so you can back that up on the field?
I mean, just all the media attention I've been getting is kind of surreal. I mean, it hasn't really hit me yet. I feel like I'm prepared for this next season, and just having Lovie behind us and having that big support system and the great coaching staff we have now, pretty sure we're going to be great.
So, Joe, he doesn't have a big head yet?
No, he's pretty much the same guy.
You've been keeping him grounded?
It's been good, but, you know, we're excited for him and the attention is well-deserved and just what our D-line's going to do this year. seeing it in camp and seeing it going forward, we're really looking forward to it.
How are you pushing each other, the defense, with the particularly up front with the offensive line, with a couple of new guys at the guard positions around you?
I think just the work ethic every day and going back and forth. I mean, the D-line will have a good day. We'll come back the next day. And just the caliber of guys we go against every day only makes us better, helps us communicate, and pushes us. So I think, you know, I think they feel the same way, but there's never an off day, you know, coming out, going against Smoot, Bain, and Chunk, and Carroll. But, you know, it's been good, and it's good for the two new guys getting going and getting kind of comfortable where they're at.
How much competition or trash talking is it about, you know, who's carrying the team? Is it the offense or the defense?
I feel like it's competition every day.
Which makes everybody better.
Yeah, it makes everyone better.
You guys are under your third head coach since you've been here in Champaign, and Coach Smith. Various voices with position coaches, coordinators coming and going. Do you feel like there's finally a sense of stability in the locker room with your teammates?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's tons of stability, and I think that's the best thing going forward. I mean, we've been through something probably no one else has been through in the country, and I hope no one goes through here again. But going forward, you know, with this staff who Lovie brought in, and with Coach Smith here, just the future looks great and stock keeps rising. So I think guys appreciate that and are ready to work. And I think you'll start seeing it more in the recruiting end as things go on and on.
How quick did you guys buy into Coach Smith and, you know, look at him as some instant credibility when he walked in the door?
I feel like we all bought in from day one. I mean, when he first walked into the door, everyone got up in their seats and was like ready
back
to listen.
Straighten up a little bit.
Yeah. Huh? Everyone basically was ready to listen from day one, really bought into the system.
So has he let out a dadgummit yet, or golly gee whiz, or you know, the next time I hear Coach cuss might be the first time.
Yeah.
So, I mean, the guy didn't raise his voice. I mean, how's that been like for you, adapting to a coach who's so even keel and keeps his emotions in check?
It's a little different, you know, different coaching styles. Coach Buckus rides us hard, but with Coach Smith, you never really see him. He's pretty even keel.
But the respect level is there, right?
Yeah,
yeah, it's there. I mean, I think 2 days ago.
Yeah, it was close.
He brought his level from like a 1 to like a 4. That was the biggest
he was going to get. Yeah. Watch out now.
That was the highest he's going to get. It's kind of scary just not knowing when the guy's going to blow up. So, I mean, we're just all waiting for it.
But the common goal here is to raise the level of Fighting Illini football and to end this season and go out in a bowl game or even bigger goals. I know you're trying to work on that now. Joe?
Yes, sir.
DJ?
Thank you.
Thanks a lot. All the best of you this season. And we're looking forward to that season opener against Murray State. Much more to come on our Fighting Illini football preview. Welcome back to our Fighting Illini football preview show. We're joined by the boss, Director of Athletics, Josh Whitman. Josh, always good to see you.
Good to see you, my friend.
And I know you feel right at home here at Memorial Stadium with the football season right around the corner. You've been at a lot of practices. My first question, how are the tight ends looking?
I tell you what, the tight ends looked good last night. It was a nice, enjoyable environment last night. They had the lights on. Everybody was in the house to watch the guys practice, and they put in some nice stuff for the tight ends last night down the red zone.
A lot of goal line packages. So whenever you see those big guys catching passes, I'm sure your eyes light up as a guy who wore the orange and blue here and had a great career. But now you're in a different role, the administrative role as the AD. And, of course, you walked in the door with a lot of credibility in your pocket in hiring Lovie Smith, convincing him to come back to the college ranks to take over the football program. I know it's kind of been said many times, but let's just go back and ask again, how did you do it? Because, you know, now that he's here and he's been coaching, he's gone through the spring, you know, the realities are starting to set in. I don't want to say the honeymoon's worn off, but he still seems like this is where he wants to be. He's smiling. He's liking the teaching aspect. How did you sell that on him early?
Well, I think, look, this is the University of Illinois, and we have a lot to sell. It's one of the world's preeminent academic institutions. We've got a tremendous football tradition here. He, of course, has incredible ties to this part of the country with the time he'd spent up in Chicago. His family's from Chicago. And I look at Lovie Smith and I see a teacher, I see an educator. And I thought that would be something that would resonate with him. And fortunately for all of us, it was.
September 3rd's coming quick. The season opener against Murray State. Of course, you would like to see this place packed. what can you tell the Fighting Illini Nation about what they can expect, you know, from the football program this year, and also just moving forward, the new direction? I mean, I know you had the hashtag of the year, we will win. You're not going to win all of them, but in terms of from a competitive standpoint, what can they expect to see?
I think they're going to see a very competitive football team, guys who are flying around the football, excited to be on the field, excited to be wearing our colors. I think there's going to be a lot of pride from our football guys on the field this year. And so excited to see them take the field. And this is a group of guys, you talk about resilient. Mm-hmm. They've been through so much these last 12, 18 months. And right. to be able to now have some stability and to allow them to focus and just work on a consistent plan month over month, I think we're just going to continue to start to see the benefits of that.
First things you said when you took the job back in February is restoring some pride in Illinois athletics, that this eye, whether it's the victory show, the block eye, whatever, that orange and blue, that it means something. And you have to instill that in all of our student athletes, not just on the football field, that what you're representing is much bigger than you. It's much bigger than the name on the back of your jersey, you know, and that's a process that's ongoing, isn't it?
It is, and I think that has been a big part of my message, both to our student athletes, to our staff, to our fans. Let's be confident and proud about who we are.
Expect to win.
Expect to win, absolutely. I think that you mentioned the hashtag, we will win, and people are so excited about the word win. And I've been telling people that, to me, the most important word in that phrase is the word will, mm-hmm. because it implies a level of expectation. Mm-hmm. I think we're trying to signal the end of wanting, hoping, aspiring. We're into a new phase. We're into doing. And we're into a point of time now where we expect to be successful in all of our sports with all of our student athletes. And we want them to walk around with their chest out and their head high and feel good about wearing that eye on their chest and understand that the University of Illinois means something and that they're going to have a tremendous education and a world-class opportunity to be competitive.
Well, there's a lot of excitement in the air about Lovie Smith, the Lovie Smith era beginning, but there has to be a level of patience as well. It all starts on September 3rd against Murray State. It'll end in a bowl game, right?
It will end in a bowl game.
All right. Hey, Josh, thanks a lot.
Appreciate everything.
More coming up here on our Fighting Illini Football Preview Show. We are joined now by Fighting Illini Football radio analyst and former Illinois All-American lineman Martin O'Donnell. Good to see you, big fella.
Hey, good to see
How's everything? Well, we're about to get off and running on this 2016 schedule against the Murray State Racers. You never know what to expect going into the season opener, but that's a fairly good test for a team under the direction of a new head coach in Lovie Smith. What do you expect from that? And also pointing to the week two matchup everyone's talking about when North Carolina comes here to Memorial Stadium under the lights at 6:30.
Yeah, I think the first two games are pretty much the exact way that you'd want to sketch it out. You have an FCS team coming in. You know, Murray State struggled a little bit last year, went 3-8. But, you know, first game under Lovie Smith, you know, allows you an opportunity to really see what you have offensively, defensively. But you know Murray State's going to come in here trying to get a win. And then the real opportunity comes in week two with North Carolina, a team that's, you know, ranked in the top 20 to open the season. Right. You know, they have one of the best tailbacks in the country in Elijah Hood coming back this season. They lose their quarterback, Marquise Williams, who really hurt the Illini mm-hmm. with his legs on the ground.
Right, sure.
But a real opportunity to play somebody that a lot of people in this country don't think you can beat. But, you know, that's why they play the games.
Be a good measuring stick. The Illini will round out the non-conference portion of the schedule against Western Michigan, then have a bye week and start the Big Ten campaign against the Big Red in Lincoln, Nebraska.
Yeah, anytime you travel to Lincoln, it's tough. And that's a program that had one of the craziest seasons last year. I think it's an opportunity for Illinois to try to see where they are with comparison to last year. Nebraska being the high water mark, you don't want to have that high water mark early in the season, but a really good road test for this Illinois team to play in a hostile environment.
The next two games on the schedule, when you have you go to host Purdue, I should say, then Rutgers, it's a good opportunity to kind of stack some wins, position yourself in the Big Ten West. But the last six games on the schedule, starting with that trip to Ann Arbor, you're looking at six teams who all played in bowl games a year ago.
Yeah, certainly. And with Illinois, a couple of the crossover games, you know, you get Michigan and Michigan State mm-hmm. there towards the end. And, you know, some people would say, oh, well, I wish you didn't have to play those elite teams. But that's why you play in the Big Ten
that's
Conference.
Right. That's you why know, you came here, right?
That's why you came here. You want to have the opportunity to play against a Michigan team that a lot of people are picking to win the Big Ten this season in year two under Jim Harbaugh, a Michigan State team that went to the college football playoff mm-hmm. last year. I think a lot of people forget that. This Illinois team needs to, you know, offensively be able to push the ball down the field a little bit and defensively be able to stop the run, because you know, when it comes to the Big Ten, stopping the run is what it's all about.
Well, you're going to get Minnesota, Michigan State, and Iowa here in Champaign. That should help before closing things out in Evanston against Northwestern. Always a rivalry game with the Land of Lincoln Trophy at stake.
Yeah, and that's been, you know, quite the rivalry last year. You know, dropping that game at Soldier mm-hmm. Field, that was certainly disappointing. Northwestern preventing Illinois from getting to a bowl game on their way to winning 10 games. But it's interesting in that if you look at Illinois and Northwestern towards the end of the season, you know, where that game is always played, if Illinois has a bowl team, the Illini have won that game. And if they don't, well, then Northwestern usually wins it. So I think that's one of the most important games of the season, not only for recruiting battles and because it's a rivalry, but really that's kind of a litmus test game to see where Illinois is on a season. You know, again, hindsight always being 20-20.
Well, one thing I do know, Lovie Smith will probably fast forward past this portion of the schedule because he's only focused on one game, and that's Murray State on September 3rd. Thanks a lot, Martin.
Hey, thanks for having
me.
Always
a pleasure. We're coming right back after a break.
Well, that's a wrap for our Fighting Illini football preview show. Thanks to all the players and coaches who joined us today, including head coach Lovie Smith, of course, and the AD Josh Whitman. All the fun gets started on September 3rd in the season opener against Murray State right here at Memorial Stadium. I'm Ryan Baker. Thanks for watching. Until the next time, go Illini.
You know, this time of year, you know it's football time, and can't wait to take this next step with our football team. You try to hide, try to find your low. I looked around for you, but you have gone. Too much space for me, you can't see. I believe when that's a left.
Nice job. Nice throw and catch.